Good morning. Today we are going to start the new module, that is module 4. Yesterday we completed the module 3. So today we are going to start module 4, that is infinite series and power series. So infinite series and power series. So what is this infinite series? Infinite series is the sum with infinitely many terms. Infinite series is the sum with infinitely many terms. Okay, infinite series is a sum with infinitely many terms. Okay, if un is a real valued sequence, then an expression of the form, see, adding like this, u1 plus u2 plus u3 to infinity is called an infinite series. So sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 like that till infinity. In symbols, it is written as sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity un. In symbols, it is written as sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity till un or sigma un. In symbols, it is written as sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity un, or it is written as sigma un. Now the partial sum. The partial sum means let sigma un is equal to u1 plus u2 plus u3 plus etc. till un to infinity. Okay, the partial sum. Let sigma un equals u1 plus u2 plus u3 etc. till un till infinity be an infinite series. This is an infinite series. Let Sn be the sum of the first n terms of the series. Let Sn be the sum of the first n terms of the series. Let Sn be the sum of the first n terms of the series. That is, Sn is equal to u1 plus u2 plus u3 etc. till un. Let Sn be the sum of the first n terms of the series, that is u1 plus u2 plus u3 till un. Sn is called the nth partial sum of the series sigma un. Sn is called as the nth, this is the called Sn is the, we take the first n term, sum of the first n terms, that is u1 plus u2 plus u3 till un. Then Sn is called the nth partial sum of the series sigma un. Sn is called the nth partial sum of the series sigma un. Now convergence, divergence and oscillation of the series. So convergence, divergence and oscillation of the series. If limit n tend to infinity Sn, if limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to S, a finite number. So you know what is Sn. First we have a series, infinite series, u1 plus u2 plus u3 till plus un till infinity. In that Sn is taken as sigma un, that is u1 plus u2 plus u3 etc. till plus un. Then if limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to S, if limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to S, a finite number. So if limit n tend to infinity Sn equal to S, a finite number, then we say that the series sigma un is convergent. If limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to S, a finite number, then we say that the series sigma un is convergent and has the sum S. If limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to S, comma, so if we take the limit of n tend to infinity Sn is equal to S, then if it's a finite number, then the series sigma un is convergent. Okay, then the series sigma un is convergent. So again, given a infinite series, that is u1 plus u2 plus u3 like this. u1 plus sigma un, that is u1 plus u2, u1 plus u2 plus u3 till un till infinity. First we write Sn. Sn means sum of n terms, that is u1 plus u2 plus u3 till n terms. u1 plus u2 plus u3 un we write. That is called Sn. This is called as the nth partial sum of the series sigma un. This is called as the nth partial sum of the series sigma un. Nth partial sum of the series sigma un. Then how to find out whether a series is convergence? Convergence means it meets at a point, we get a definite answer. Or divergence. Divergence means it goes to infinity. And oscillation means same value. When you add 3 terms, 2, when you add 4 terms, minus 2, when you add 5 terms, 2, again minus 2, like that. So limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal, first we find out the limit of the nth term, that is Sn. Limit n tend to infinity Sn, this is called sum of partial sum, nth partial sum of the series. First we find the limit n tend to infinity of Sn. If it is equal to S, a finite number, then we say that the series sigma un is convergent. a finite number, then we say that the series, then we say that the series sigma un is convergent and has the sum s. If limit n tend to infinity, that is the sum of partial, nth partial sum of the series, when you apply the limit n tend to infinity is a fixed number s or a finite number s, then we say that the series sigma un is convergent and has the same answer what you get here, that is the sum s. Now, if limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to plus or minus infinity, if limit n tend to infinity Sn equals plus or minus infinity, then we say that the series sigma un is divergent. If limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to plus or minus infinity, then we say that the series sigma un is divergent. If limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to plus or minus infinity, then we say that the series sigma un is divergent. So if limit n tend to infinity Sn is a fixed number or a finite number, say s, then we say that the series sigma un is convergent and has the sum as s. Suppose when you apply the limit, if you get infinity plus or minus infinity, then we say that the series sigma un is divergent, there is no end, it's divergent. Okay, and if limit n tend to infinity Sn equals s, if limit n tend to infinity Sn equals s, or if limit n tend to infinity Sn equals s or s dash, see there are two answers, if we get s or s dash. If limit n tend to infinity Sn is equal to s or s dash, then we say that the series is oscillating. Then we say oscillating means once we get s, and the time we get, when we take two terms sum we get s, when we take three terms we get s dash, when we take four terms we get s, when we take five terms we get s dash, like this. So if we get s or s dash, then we say that the sigma un is oscillatory. So okay, consider the examples. We'll see some examples. Now again, if you want to recall what we studied, a series will be given till infinity. For example, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, 5, etc. till infinity. Take it as un. Then we find Sn, the nth partial sum. That means 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n terms. Then apply limit n tend to infinity to Sn. Then apply limit n tend to infinity to Sn. If you get a finite number, say S, then we say that what? The series is convergent. Convergent means there is an answer for that. If we get, when you apply the limit n tend to infinity Sn, if you get plus or minus infinity, then we say that the series is divergent. Then we say that the series is divergent. That means the answer is infinity. It goes on extending. If limit n tend to infinity Sn is s or s dash, there are two answers. That means when we add two terms, we get s. When we add three terms, we get s dash. When we add four terms, we get s. When we add five terms, we get s dash. When we add six terms, we get s. When we add seven terms, we get s dash. Then we say that it is oscillatory. Now, if we consider this here, 1 plus half plus 1 by 4 plus etc. till 1 by 2 power n plus 1 etc. till infinity. If you consider this, so three problems are there. First one is 1 plus half plus 1 by 4 plus etc. till 1 by 2 power n minus 1. It's very clear, right? Because here first term means it is 1 by 2 power 0. Okay. Then 1 by 2 power 1. 2 power 1 means second term. Second term is 1 by 2 power 1. So third term is 1 by 2 power 2. Fourth term will be 1 by 2 power 3. So naturally nth term will be 1 less. 1 by 2 power n minus 1. 1 by 2 power n minus 1. Okay. So this is clear. Now, very simple, how to find the nth term of the series. Okay. Now, the second problem is 1 plus 2 plus 3 till infinity. Third is oscillating. You can say 2 minus 2 plus 2, like that, till the nth term will be minus 1 power n plus 1. The nth term will be minus 1 power n plus 1 into 2 till infinity. Okay, we take the first one. Now, how to find the sum? Sn, un, etc. See, we take, 1 plus 1 by 2, 1 by 4 till infinity. We write its nth term. So when we write its nth term, we get 1 by 2 power n minus 1. Now when you look at it carefully, you have studied many type of series in your lower classes. arithmetic series, if there is a common difference, second term minus first term is D. Geometric series, if there is a common ratio, third term divided by second term is R. Okay, then you studied geometric series, then harmonic series, it is the reciprocal of arithmetic series. Clear? So now, if you look at this carefully, half divided by 1 is half. 1 by 4 divided by half is half. So there is a common ratio. So it is a geometric series. So it is a geometric series of the form a plus ar plus ar squared. It goes on till ar power n minus 1 plus etc. till infinity. So it is a geometric series of the form a plus ar plus ar squared plus etc. plus ar n minus 1 till infinity. Yeah? So what will be the sum? Hence the sum is the geometric series, you know, the sum to infinity formula is the geometric series. The sum to infinity formula is S infinity is equal to A by 1 minus R. A by 1 minus R. So what happens here? We take limit n tends to infinity Sn. So we take the first n terms. I told Sn. We take the first n terms. So limit n tends to infinity Sn will be 1 plus half plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2 power n minus 1. So naturally it is a geometric series. So first we find out from the formula. If you can't apply the formula, then you apply the limit directly by the concepts of limit. Now here you can use the formula because it is a geometric series. The sum to infinity is a by 1 minus r. So 1 by till infinity here. So a by 1 minus r is the ratio. A is the first term. So first term is 1 divided by 1 minus r is half. So now what happens when r is half? When r is half, you get here when r is half. What do you get? When r is half, 1 by 1 minus half. 1 minus half is half again. That is actually 2. Okay. So a limit n tends to Sn is 2, and this 2 is a finite number. It's clear. This 2 is a finite number. You know that. 2 is a finite number. You know that. Correct? So 2 is a finite number. So hence the given series is convergent. So very simple. You can see here, see. First, the series, question number, okay, the series, we write its nth term. That you should be very, looking at the series properly, you can write it. See, first term is 1. 1 means I can take it as all the denominators are powers of 2. So, first term I can write as 1 by 2 power 0. Second term I can write as 1 by 2 power 1. Third term I can write as 1 by 2 squared. Fourth term I can write as 1 by 2 cubed, like that. So, nth term will be 1 less. First term 1 by 2 power 0, second term 1 by 2 power 1, third term is 1 by 2 squared. So naturally the nth term will be 1 by 2 power n minus 1. Okay, this is a geometric series and it is of the type A plus AR. Geometric series of the type A plus AR squared. It goes on till AR power n minus 1 till infinity. Hence its sum is given to be A by 1 minus R. Its sum is given to be A by 1 minus R. Okay, limit n tends to infinity, Sn is limit n tends to infinity, the sum, that is 1 plus half plus 1 by 4 etc. till 1 by 2 power n minus 1. So this will be nothing but this is a, when once as the concept says, when you have to find the sum till infinity, first we find the sum of n terms, the nth partial sum, that is Sn. So that is written here, nth partial sum, and apply the limit n tends to infinity. And since it is a geometric series means there is a common ratio. There is a common ratio. So when there is a, so S infinity formula is there for the geometric series, that is A by 1 minus R, you know that from your high school studies. So 1 by A is the first term, 1, R is the common ratio, half divided by 1, half second term divided by first term. And also it is third term divided by second term, like that goes on. So A divided by 1 minus half, that will be 2. It's because 1 minus half, half, 1 by half will be 2. Okay, so limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equal to 2. Limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equal to 2, which is a finite number. So when it is a finite number, we say that the series is convergent. This is one method. So this is the method, first method what you're studying to decide whether a series is convergent or divergent or it is oscillating. Now second term we'll see how to calculate. So second problem is 1 plus 2 plus 3 etc. till infinity. This is counting numbers, natural numbers, 1 plus 2 plus 3 till infinity. These type of problems, many problems you have done. I know that you have done many problems. Okay. Now here, we take the sum to n terms. That is the nth partial sum. Again, we take here the nth partial sum. That is Sn is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus n terms. We take the nth partial sum. Sn is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus etc. till n terms. And 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n terms is given by n into n plus 1 by 2. 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n terms is given by n into n plus 1 by 2. So now limit n tends to infinity Sn. You know how to apply the limit here. You remove n outside, so it will be n squared. 1 plus 1 by n. Limit n tends to infinity 1 by n is 0. So n squared is there in the numerator. So limit n tends to Sn will be infinity. This will be infinity. You know how to apply limit. You studied the concept of limits. Complete chapter in your PU level. Even in Mass 1, that is first semester, you have studied limits. So applying limit for this, try to apply. If you have doubt, you ask me. Limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equal to infinity. So once it is infinity, okay, once it is infinity, then we say that the series is divergent. Once it is infinity, we say that the series is divergent. We say that the series is divergent. Clear? Now, oscillating. Oscillating means, because infinity we got, we say that the series is divergent. I hope it is clear. Now we take this third example. See the third example. 2 minus 2 plus 2, etc. So now here we have 2 minus 2 plus 2, etc. till plus of minus 1 power n plus 1 into 2 till infinity. Is it clear? Till infinity. Okay. Just checking. Because some students are coming now, just checking it. So Sn is equal to 2 minus 2 plus 2, like that, minus. This will, what will be the nth term? It has, the nth term will be, you can see, first term. That is minus 1 power 0. First term will be minus 1 power 0 into 2. Second term will be minus 1 power what? First term minus 1 power 0. Second term minus 1 power 3, we want negative. We want here negative. We want here negative. So minus 1 power n plus 1. Here positive. Here again negative. So the nth term, always when there is positive, negative, we take the nth term as minus 1 power n plus 1 and 2 is repeating. We take it as minus 1 power n plus 1 and 2 is repeating. So Sn is equal to 2 minus 2 plus 2, like that, till minus 1 power n plus 1, 2. That is the sum to n terms will be like this. Outright sum to n terms, that is nth partial sum. The nth term we are writing, but we are finding the sum to infinity. So here you can see, this has got two sums. This has got two answers, clearly, because once, see, for example, if I add two terms, 2 minus 2, 0. If I add three terms, 2 minus 2, 0, we get plus 2, like that. If you add four terms, 0. If you add five terms, you get plus 2, like that. So limit n tend to infinity, Sn is 0, if n is even, see. If you add two terms, 0. If you add 3 terms, it is 2. If you add 4 terms, 0. If you add 5 terms, it is 2. Like that. So, limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equal to 0, if n is even. Then limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equal to 2, if n is odd. If n is odd. Therefore, the series is oscillating. We say that the series is oscillating. Here we say that the series is oscillating. Now, there is an important condition that is called as a necessary condition. Okay, later on we'll use it in problems. If a series of positive terms is convergent, then the limit of its nth term is equal to 0. Very important statement. It will be used in problems later. If a series of positive terms is convergent, then the limit of its nth term is equal to 0. If a series of positive terms is convergent, then the limit of its nth term is equal to 0. We'll use it in problems later. Please note this result. If a series of positive terms is convergent, then the limit of its nth term is equal to 0. Now note, the above condition can be used to test. Why the above condition? So what is this condition? If a series of positive terms is convergent, then the limit of its nth term is equal to 0. If a series of positive terms is convergent, then the limit of its nth term is equal to 0. Remember it. Now, the above condition can be used to test the non-convergence. Using this condition, that's called necessary condition, we can test whether the series is convergent or non-convergent. It can be used to test the non-convergence of a given positive term series. It can be used to test the non-convergence of a given positive term series. If a given series of positive terms you take sigma un is convergent, if it is convergent, then by that condition, limit n tends to infinity un is equal to 0. This is that necessary condition. You have to know it. Okay. So if a given series of positive terms sigma un is convergent, then by the necessary condition of convergence, limit n tends to infinity un equals 0. Again, I repeat, if I understand the statement, if a given series of positive terms sigma un is convergent, then by the necessary condition, for convergence, limit n tends to infinity un equals 0. Hence, so if limit n tends to infinity un is 0 is the necessary condition for a series of positive terms to be convergent. Okay. Now here, if limit n tends to infinity un is not equal to 0 for a given series, then the series sigma un is divergent. So the necessary condition is limit n tends to infinity un is equal to 0 for a series un to be convergent. At the same time, if limit n tends to infinity un is not equal to 0 for a given series sigma un, then the series sigma un will be divergent. Okay. Now, see here. Problems. See the problems. Test for convergence of the series. One problem is there. 1 by 2 plus 2 by 3 plus 3 by 4 plus n by n plus 1 etc. till infinity. Now, sigma un is equal to, we take it as sigma un, half plus 1, 2 by 3 plus 3 by 4. In the numerator, you can see 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n terms. In the denominator, first term is 2, second term is 3, third term is 4. So, the nth term will be n plus 1, n by n plus 1 till infinity. Now, the nth term un is equal to n by n plus 1. So, to test the convergence, we use the necessary condition. We have to see limit n tends to infinity un, what happens to limit n tends to infinity un. So now, limit n tends to infinity un is equal to limit n tends to infinity this un, that is n by n plus 1, that is the nth term of this given series. So what happens, you have studied in Maths 1, that is first semester mathematics, also in your PU level, how to find the limits when n tends to infinity, when n tends to 0, etc. So here, limit n tends to infinity n, what I do here, I remove n outside. So I can write it as 1 plus 1 by n, n and n get cancelled, and 1 by infinity is 0. When you apply the limit n tends to infinity 1 by 0, limit n tends to infinity 1 by n is 0 because 1 by infinity is 0. So it happens when you apply the limit 1 by 1, that is 1, and 1 is not equal to 0. So limit n tends to infinity un not equal to 0. So the condition is for the series to be convergent, limit n tends to infinity un equals 0. But here you get limit n tends to infinity un equals 1, which is not equal to 0. Hence, by the above condition, that is the necessary condition for convergence of a series, the given series is not convergent. Hence, for a series to be convergent, limit n tends to infinity un should be equal to 0. But here we get limit n tends to infinity un not equal to 0. Therefore, the given series is not convergent. So, if it is not convergent, the given series sigma un is divergent. Okay, we will take one more example. Test for convergence of the series. Sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity. One plus 1 by n power n. Test for convergence of the series. Sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity. 1 plus 1 by n power n. So we take this as sigma un, that is sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 plus 1 by n power n. So un is equal to 1 plus 1 by n power n. We apply the limit. Limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by n power n. So this is a standard formula in limits. You have studied in your PUC, also you have studied in first semester mathematics. Limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by n power n is equal to e, and e is a constant number between 2 and 3. So e is not equal to 0. So limit n tends to infinity, again un is not equal to 0. So by the necessary condition above, we can say that the given series is not convergent. So the given series sigma un is divergent. It's not convergent means it will be divergent. Oscillating comes later, we test later. Now, problem 3, test, see these are all important problems, don't neglect this. Test for convergence the series 1 squared by 1 plus 1 squared plus 2 squared by 1 plus 2 squared plus 3 squared by 1 plus 3 squared. So the nth term will be naturally here, it will be n squared divided by 1 plus n squared. Very simple, till infinity. We take sigma un. First we write sigma un. So sigma un will be equal to, as you can see, 1 squared by 1 plus 1 squared plus 2 squared by 1 plus 2 squared plus 3 squared by 1 plus 3 squared plus it goes on, the nth term will be n squared by 1 plus n squared. Okay, till infinity, we want only till n terms. So un, the nth term will be n squared by 1 plus n squared. Now we apply limit for this. Limit n tends to infinity un. So limit n tends to infinity n squared by 1 plus n squared. This type of problems you have solved many problems in Maths 1 in your first semester, also in QC. So what we do, whenever infinity comes, we take n squared to the denominator. So we remove n squared outside. Limit n tends to infinity n squared by n squared into 1 plus 1 by n squared. So this 1 by n squared will be 1 by infinity, it will be 0. So it will be 1 by 1. When you apply limit here, this will be 0. 1, because 1 by infinity is 0, so 1 by 1 is 1, which is not equal to 0. So limit n tends to infinity un is not equal to 0. Limit n tends to infinity un is not equal to 0. Hence by the necessary condition. What is the necessary condition? For a series which converges to infinity, which is tends to infinity, which tends sum to infinity, the test for convergence, for it to positive series to be convergent, is that for a series sigma u, for a series un to be convergent, the necessary condition is that limit n tends to infinity un equals 0. But here you got limit n tends to infinity not equal to 0, so the given series is not convergent. So if the given series is not convergent, then we say that sigma un is divergent. If it is not convergent, then we say that sigma un is divergent. So much, we'll continue it in the next class. So once again, what I did today, I will recall. So today we started module 4. All of you should know it. Many are absent, I know that. We started module 4. In module 4, we have got infinite series and power series, and then special series also later. So infinite series. You can see here the module 4 heading. Your syllabus. So module 4, infinite series and power series. Okay, infinite series and power series. Power series you will get Bessel function, all that. That we'll see later. So in infinite series, first you studied nth partial sum. So infinite series means it will be like this, u1 plus u2 plus etc. to un till infinity, infinite series. In symbols it is written as sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity or sigma un. Partial sum, that means Sn, that is nothing but the sum to n terms, nth partial sum. That is only the n terms are taken, u1 plus u2 plus u3 till un. This is called nth partial sum, that is of the series, that is sigma un. Now convergence, divergence and oscillation. If limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equal to S. If limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equal to S, a finite number, then we say that sigma un is convergent. If limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equal to S, a finite number, then we say that the series sigma un is convergent and has the sum S. If limit n tends to infinity, Sn is plus or minus infinity, then we say that the given series is divergent. If limit n tends to infinity, Sn has got two answers, S or S dash. If it has got two answers, that is S or S dash, then we say that it is oscillating. Two answers means when you add two terms, you get S. When you add three terms, you get S dash, like that. Oscillating series. We solved 2-3 examples by using about that geometric series, all that. We solved the example, just go through it. Then we came across another condition called as the necessary condition, which is very important. If a series of positive terms is convergent, then the limit of its nth term is equal to 0. So we can say if the limit of its nth term, if the limit of any series, limit of the nth term of any series is equal to 0, then we say that the series is convergent. Okay? If it's not equal to 0, we say it's divergent. So like that, first we find the nth term and apply the limit. If you get If you get not equal to 0, the series is divergent. If you get 0, the series is convergent. So we solved all these type of problems in this. And then we end, that is the last part of this today's session. So to summarize, we studied infinite series. We studied what is Sn, the nth partial sum. And then we studied the necessary condition. The necessary condition for a series, positive series, sigma un, to be convergent is that limit n tends to infinity un equals 0. We solved problems in that. Now I repeat, every class, every session I am telling all of you, write the notes. I am going to check it. It is an assignment. And also one assignment, one is there, given in the class. Do it. Okay? And those students who missed the class, this video will be uploaded in the afternoon in the YouTube, MITK channel. Please go through it and prepare seriously for the exams. You will not get time later. Thanks. All the best.